Chapter 10, Hypothesis Testing with Two Samples. Introduction. Chapter 10 explores the various methods used to compare two groups in hypothesis tests. These tests are commonly used in studies that examine the effects of different treatments or interventions on two separate populations. The chapter covers hypothesis tests for two population means, two population proportions, and matched or paired samples. It also introduces the Aspin-Welch t-test, which is used to compare two independent population means. Those means could have unknown and possibly unequal population standard deviations. Learning objectives. By the end of this chapter, you should be able to 1. Understand the difference between hypothesis tests for two means and two proportions. 2. Determine whether the population's standard deviations are known or unknown. 3. Identify the appropriate distribution to use for hypothesis testing. 4. Calculate the test statistic and degrees of freedom for hypothesis tests involving two means. 5. Interpret the results of hypothesis tests and draw conclusions based on the data. Key points. Hypothesis tests for two means compare the means of two populations to determine if there is a significant difference between them. The Aspin-Welch t-test is used when the population standard deviations are unknown and possibly unequal. The null hypothesis states that there is no significant difference between the means of the two populations, while the alternative hypothesis implies that there is evidence to reject the null hypothesis and that a statistically significant difference does exist between the means. The p-value is the probability of obtaining a test statistic as extreme as the one observed, assuming the null hypothesis is true. Cohen's D is a measure of effect size that quantifies the difference between two means relative to the pooled standard deviation. Real-world application. One real-world application of hypothesis testing with two samples is in educational research. For example, a study may compare the effectiveness of two different teaching methods on student learning outcomes. By conducting a hypothesis test, researchers can determine if there is a significant difference in the mean scores of students who were taught using different methods. This information can help educators make informed decisions about instructional practices and improve student outcomes. Conclusion. Chapter 10 provides a comprehensive overview of hypothesis testing with two samples. It covers the different types of tests for comparing means and proportions, as well as the Aspin-Welch t-test for comparing independent means with unknown and possibly unequal standard deviations. The chapter emphasizes the importance of understanding the null and alternative hypotheses, calculating the test statistic and degrees of freedom, and interpreting the results of hypothesis tests. By mastering the concepts and techniques presented in this chapter, you will be equipped to analyze and draw conclusions from data involving two samples. Thank you.